We have a European call option here, and two things we'll do. We have a call option here. I can write CE for call option, and then I will keep some money with me. E power minus RT minus T. This is my portfolio. If you study CT1, you must be knowing how to make portfolios, okay? We'll do for forward contract as well. Now here, in my portfolio, I have money and I have one call option, okay? This is the call option. I have call option means it will come with a price, and I have money also. This is my portfolio. I have to establish one portfolio. Suppose whatever money I have, from that amount, I kept aside this money, okay? Or you can say, I established a portfolio here. Then what will happen? I don't know the value of the call option here. What will happen after some time? At big time T, what will happen? That's what we'll see. After some time, you can say this is the expiry date. Call option is there. So that option is there with me now. That call option is there with me. What I will do with this, that's a separate thing. But the paper, okay, the legal document, the document is there with me. Suppose I have a call option, okay, and money will grow. So now money grew to K. I have K and one call option. Because I wanted 2K, I'm the buyer of the call option. I've not written. I'm the buyer of the call option, okay? Call option means I'm buyer of the call option. Now, I have amount K. So at time T, I wanted to make sure that I will have K amount at time T. So that I can go and if required, I can exercise the contract with the writer. That's why to make sure that I have money T, because I have to exercise, I have to keep the amount here when I enter this contract. Okay, when I purchase the call option along with this one, I kept this amount so that by this time T, October 2018, now October 2020, here by now I have this amount because I kept that amount. The amount now grew to K. You see the interest rate is given E power minus R T minus T. So here capital T minus small t is the duration. R is the continuous rate, continuous compounding rate. So I have the call option, I have money. Now it's up to me whether I will exercise the contract or not. I have two cases, okay? Case one is, suppose the stock price in the market, that is the value is ST now, this is the time. It was ST at this time, small t, now capital ST. Suppose ST is greater than K, then what will be my portfolio value? Yes, this is a question. If ST is greater than K, then what will be the value of my portfolio? In this case, what is the value of this whole portfolio? Okay, the portfolio means both. So if ST is greater than K, as a buyer of the call option, I am supposed to give K to purchase the share. So share will come to me and I have to give K. You have to see which one is more. K is less. Suppose K is 100, ST is 150. So if I exchange K with ST, it will be beneficial for me. I will get benefit. For that reason, I will try to exercise the contract. I will definitely exercise the contract and I will give K. Okay. Suppose these are the two parties. Now seller is there with me, buyer, I am the buyer. I will give K and then I will get XT. ST, okay, seller will give me the share. Okay, the share price is ST now according to this notation. And I will do that, I will exit the contract because the value of the share is more. Okay, we can compare the market value of the share and whatever is the strike price. And then what will happen, because I will exercise the contract, now this is not there with me, I have no more option, and I will give this, and finally I will get ST. So my portfolio value, let me write PV, portfolio value, my portfolio value will be exactly ST. No legal document, no legal contract, and no money also. Now ST, okay. If I want to sell it, I want to get cash, I will get, but that will be greater than K, so I am happy. Whatever I spent here, that's a separate thing, okay. However, in this case where ST is less than K, suppose the share price will not go to K, then what will happen? Suppose share price will not be greater than K, it's less than K, okay, even equal to K, so you can keep here or here, then what will be my portfolio value? If the share price is less than K, then what will happen? So I have to write ST here. ST, the share price is less than K, then what will happen? I will not exercise the contract. If I will not exercise the contract, in any case, contract is meaningless after this time. Okay, this has no value. I will have K. My portfolio value will be K. But I want to write both of these in one way, okay, this one and this one. I want to write using one line. How can I write? I will change a bit, I will write this way. Portfolio value, okay, is equal to ST exactly here, and here in this case I will write greater than ST. This I can write. I have exactly K, but now K is more than ST, okay, so I can say PV is greater than ST, and here I can write PV is equal to XT. I will combine this one and the modified version of this one. It's exactly K, okay, but K is more than ST here, right? I have written here K is more than ST. If you want, you can write equality sign here, okay, doesn't matter wherever you write. So what will happen if PV is greater than ST? Then what will happen? If PV is equal to K, PV will be greater than ST. Suppose PV is 100 and this is ST is only 90. Okay, so 100 is greater than 90. My PV is greater than ST. Now what will happen? I will find here. What should be the portfolio value here? That is what I want to know. If my portfolio value here is this, greater than or equal to ST, my portfolio value should be greater than or equal to ST. Okay, that is what you need to remember, because my total portfolio value here, that is greater than or equal to the share price at capital time T, my portfolio value here should be greater than or equal to the share price here. So what is my portfolio value? I must have purchased this call option from the seller, okay, so I must have paid the amount CT, and this amount I kept, okay, so that amount K e power minus R T minus T in the risk-free investment, we say risk-free investment, that's why we use R, okay, so we save this amount so that it will exactly go to K with a fixed increase. So this is what I spent, I must have spent here with small t, everything. That must be greater than or equal to ST. Then what will happen? If you go here, we want to find an upper bound. So CT will be greater than or equal to ST minus K e power minus R T minus T. Okay, so CT must be greater than or equal to ST minus K e power minus T minus T. CT, the minimum value of CT is this one. So this is upper bound or lower bound? Upper bound or lower bound? When I say minimum value, who can answer? Upper bound or lower bound?
Sir, is it lower bound?
Lower bound, right? So the minimum value, okay? We'll do the upper bound later. Let me write lower bound. So the minimum value of CT is this one, okay? Because CT can never be less than this value, whatever value. See, you use any model, Black-Scholes formula, whatever formula you can use, CT will never be less than this value. Now I have a question. I'll show you the question. Here, this is the question, okay? You have to answer this. Suppose that the current price of a share is 115. Let me write ST 115. The exercise price of a 3-month call option, okay, on X is 100. So K, I have to write 100. What is T minus T? T minus T, 3 divided by 12, okay, 3 months return, exercise price is given, the continuously compounded risk-free rate, that is R is given 0.12. Now you have to apply everything, you have to apply the formula, and you have to find a lower bound, okay, not upper bound. So if you write everything here, let me write CT ST minus here, I have to write K, that is 100, e power minus R T minus T, that is 3 upon 12. Minus 0.12. So if you use calculator, CT will be greater than or equal to 17.96. You can check this. Now I want to know from you, what is the meaning of this? Yes or no? What is the meaning of this?
The lower bound is 17.96. It means the CT value should be more than or equal to this.
That means if you go and purchase call option, the minimum value, okay, if you purchase the call option, the minimum value in this scenario is 17.96. This is the minimum value. That means the price of the call option, if you want to purchase call option at time T, you have to pay 17.96. Considering that the share price is 115 and 3 month call option price is 100. That means if the price will go to 125, you will get 25. Even the price comes down to 105, then also you will get 5. Okay, if this goes to 130, your payoff will be 30. If it goes to 90, your payoff will be 0. You will not exercise. This is the exercise price. So in that case, what is the amount you should be prepared to pay? See, normally what happens, if you are purchasing a call option, this is 115, if it's 125 or 150, then you will wait and you see that this 115 grows to more than 150, then you will make a profit. Here in this case, it's even less than 115, okay? So it's good, you have to pay some amount. If the share price increases, anyway you will make a profit, okay? Even if it comes down up to 100, then that will be good. But yeah, for that we have to see how much price you have to pay for that option. That also you have to see, 17.96 minimum. So if I ask you the question, what is the value of CT here, the call option value, what will be your answer? Who can say? We got CT minimum value 17.96. What is the exact value of CT? Who can answer? Any idea by this time? No idea, absolutely. Okay, we have to learn Black-Scholes model. So what we are doing now is, before going to the general formula Black-Scholes model, lot of development will happen. You have to use stochastic process, Brownian motion, all that, and lot of derivations are there, though those are not required in exam. But yeah, you have to study a lot to know Black-Scholes formula. So if you apply Black-Scholes formula, you will have an idea. Okay, no, you will not have an idea. Now we have an idea, minimum value we know, but once you study Black-Scholes formula, you will be able to know exact value. We don't know whether it's 50 or 60 or 25 or 27. Absolutely, we have no idea. But what we know is it's greater than or equal to 7.96. So some information, without going to the math details, without learning a whole lot of things, we have some idea now. Okay, so even those who never studied any option, never studied actual science, they will have a rough idea. It should be greater than or equal to 17.96. That is what we got to know. Similar to this, we'll try to find the lower bound. Sorry, not this. Similar to this, we'll find the lower bound, okay, of European put option. Now let me write here, put option. Lower bound. This is European put option, okay? So let's make one portfolio here. The value here we'll find, and we'll insert one line here. This is time t, it could be 0, but this is the notation, this is capital time t. Now in case of put option, you want to buy a put option, okay? You are again the buyer, you are not the seller, you are the buyer, so that option will be there with you, okay? I have to write here put option, okay? P for put. Put option, and you have to keep something here. What is that? You have to own share now, okay? It will cost you some money. This is the share, okay? Let me write here. And put option gives you the right to sell the share to the seller. Now see, there might be a confusion again. Seller, you can say writer. You will sell it, okay? You will exchange, you can see. You will exchange with the seller. Now what will happen after this time? What will happen? You bought this one from the seller, you are the buyer, okay? You are the buyer of the put option. You are the buyer and this guy is the seller, okay? Now what will happen? Suppose you will take case 1, ST is greater than K, then what will happen? Then we will see the case ST less than K. Now the option is there, okay? This is the legal document, you can say. This is your put option. And the share is also there with you. Here you must have purchased by paying this amount. Now the share price is ST. Whatever is ST. It may be greater than small t or less than, we don't know. Share price, according to the share price movement, you can know ST at time t. Now what will happen? At capital time t, you have the share. You will forcibly you will sell it to the seller. Again, when I say seller, not the seller of the share, okay? Seller of the option. Again, when we say seller here, or we can say writer, okay? Let me write writer otherwise. So, seller of the put option, okay? Not seller of the share. Now, I'm the buyer of the put option. I'm the buyer of the put option. That means I purchase the option. Okay, I'm the buyer of the put option means I purchase the option, but I'm not obliged to sell it, but I have the option to sell it. If it will profit me, definitely I will sell it, okay? And I will exchange my share. I will receive K from this guy, the seller of the put option, and then I will give my share to this guy. I will sell it, okay? So before selling, I have to make it sure that the market price, because I will get K, market price is greater than K. This is the case that will profit me, because I am the buyer of the put option. I will give the share which is not worth K, I will receive K. So what will happen? I will get K and I will sell it to the seller. I will sell it to the seller of the put option, okay? Obviously, I will get the market price ST. Okay, ST I will give him, I will get K. The opposite. So K will come to me, K is greater than ST, it's fine. In this case, I will not exercise the contract. I will not sell the share to the seller of the call option, to the writer of the call option, to avoid any confusion. Let me change it to writer. Okay, writer of this call option is there. I will not sell the share to him, because if I sell the share to him or her, whoever, I will get only K from him. This is exercising. okay, sorry, I will sell it. This guy means I am exercising actually. If I exercise the contract, that means I am selling the contract at a price called K. However, if I sell it in the market, I will get ST. And now I know that ST is greater than K. If I sell in the market, I will get ST. But if I exercise the contract, that is selling to the writer of the put option, I will get K. Which one is greater? ST is greater, so I will not exercise the contract. I will keep it. Its value is ST, which is more than K. Why to get K and exercise the contract with the, say, writer of the put option? Not, right? So my value, my portfolio final value is my share. That is, my value is ST here. And in this case, my value is K, okay? Because K is greater, I will sell it and I will receive K. Here I will not sell it, I will not sell the share, but this is worthless anyway because the time is over now. This legal document has no value. I had the option to exercise, but I didn't exercise, or I exercise, it doesn't matter. Ultimately, I have to see whether I have the share with me or I have some money after exercising the contract, okay? That is what you have to see. So what is my final value? What is my payoff? What is the final value I got from this kind of a portfolio I established at small time t? That is what I need to see. My value is equal to ST here K, okay? So that is equal to K. My final value, my portfolio value, I can write here, my portfolio value is either equal to K, I can write is equal to K, or greater than K, because this amount is greater than K. I can write is equal to K, is equal to ST, I can write, but rather it will not give me anything. I will write this is equal to or greater than K, so that I will have one single number, okay? Because this is ST in this case, okay? In the second case I have written, which is greater than K, because ST is greater than K. So my portfolio value, I can write here, that will be greater than or equal to K at time T, my portfolio value. So what will be my portfolio value here? That should be greater than or equal to, first of all, what is my portfolio value here? I purchased this one, I must have paid PT, that is the notation for put option, plus to purchase the share, I must have spent ST. This is the portfolio value here. That must be greater than or equal to K value here. This is money, okay? Money we have to discount. So what will happen? PT should be greater than or equal to K e power minus R T minus ST, okay? So PT must be greater than or equal to K e power minus R T minus ST. This is what you need to remember. This is the lower bound for the put option. This is the lower bound for the put option, okay? So this is second equation. This is the second one. This is the first one. So here call option minimum value. Remember ST minus K e power minus R T minus T. Here put option minimum value K e power minus R T minus T minus ST. This you have to know, okay? Then we'll go to American. If you consider this one and you have time t here, time t here, though we don't do much about American, mostly we have only for European, okay. This is time t and this is time t. This is small time t, this is capital time t. And the buyer, the premium amount, that amount is ct. Remember, we write ct here, capital. Here we write capital, there small, ct. Now what will happen? Suppose you purchase one call option, American call option, okay. In Indian stock market, now everything is European only. So if you purchase now this one, okay, call option, you have to pay capital CT. And you establish the portfolio, like last time, you have to keep money, okay, whatever money you are supposed to exchange here, the present value, that you need to keep here. In the risk-free, you have to make the risk-free risk-free investment. You have to make the risk-free investment. You have to fix deposit. You have to save in the bank, okay, for this time period. What will happen? This will grow to K, okay. And you have the document also, that to exercise the option, you have the right. You are not obliged to. What will happen is, you can exercise at any time you want, but now we are doing the case where dividends are not payable. So we are considering the special case here where dividends are not payable, okay. If dividends are not payable during this tenure, then whether this party, okay, the buyer, whether the buyer will exercise the contract or not, buyer, although option is there, buyer will not exercise the contract, although it's American, okay, buyer will not exercise the contract during. So what will happen in case of a call option? It doesn't matter whether you are allowed, it doesn't matter whether you purchase American call option or European call option, that will remain the same, the bound will remain the same, okay. If I change it to capital CT, I will get the same bound here. But remember, even here also we didn't consider any dividend now, that will come later. Now there is an assumption, assuming that no dividends are payable during this tenure of small t to capital T, this will hold good, okay. Now this we have to know, although option is there, why this buyer, the buyer of the call option will not exercise the contract, that you have to know. If you want to know that, there is one inequality we use, that you have to know. If you know the inequality, you will be able to answer. Any idea? Okay, you think this way. Suppose at this time you are the buyer and here the writer, okay, salary, the writer is waiting so that he will come. Now if you are allowed to exercise, what is the amount you will get? And if you will not exercise, but you want to anyway, you want to sell it in the market, okay, you want to sell it in the market, how much you will get? We'll compare, okay, we'll compare these two. Now suppose you will sell it in the market, how much you will get? If you exercise, how much you will get? That you have to know. Tell me if you, any of you can answer. If you sell it to the writer, okay, if you sell it to the writer, what you will sell? You will sell the option. Options, this option, if you sell it to the writer, how much you will get? If you sell it to the if you sell it in the market, how much you will get? That is what you have to know. If you sell in the market, how much you will get? Any idea? Yes, Anu. If you sell it in the market, how much you will get? Okay, you tell me, if you exercise with this guy, okay, then what will be, what is the final value you will have? Suppose this time is other than t, suppose u, okay, u is this time, any time between t and t, this time is u, okay, this is u, at this time you will sell it. So if you sell it, then you have to give k, right? Why you will sell it? First of all, you know that at time u, SU value is, suppose, you are selling the contract, right? Selling the contract, selling the option contract, you are selling the option contract, okay? So if you sell it in the market to someone else, suppose, though practically it will not happen this way, there is no fixed one, okay, whoever is available to take, you can sell it. But now coming to this one, suppose you will sell it to this guy, okay, you will exercise, or exercise in the market practically also. If you exercise, if you sell it, they are different, okay. Exercising means what? The difference you will get, because you have to give K and you have to receive SU, and obviously SU is greater than K, that's why you want to exercise now, otherwise why you will exercise, right? So your final value will be SU minus K, where U is any time between small t and capital T. However, if you sell it in the market, you will get CU. The notation CT we have given for call option, CU. And we know that, see, price here, call option value is CT, okay? This call option value. So if you sell it in the market at time U, the notation is CU, okay? So surprisingly, you can say the CU, okay, CU is always greater than SU minus K. But remember, the assumption is no dividends are payable during the tenure of the contract. In that case, CU will always be greater than or equal to SU minus K. This is what you have to know. So why this will happen? Because we know that CU is always greater than or equal to SU minus K. And this is the value you get if you sell it in the market, open market, okay? If you sell it and if you exercise, you have the option to exercise any time, you have chosen the time, this time you think that it will benefit you, then when you see the final benefit, this benefit is less than actually if you sell it elsewhere. See, selling is allowed for European option also, you can sell it, not a problem. When it comes to exercising in European call option, you have only one point, that is fixed. In case of American, you can exercise anytime. We never talked about selling. You can sell it anytime in case of European option, American option as well. If you sell it, what will happen? If you sell it here, immediately you have CT, because you purchased it CT. If you sell it, its value will be different. So its value will be different. Why its value will be different? That you must be knowing. There is a concept of time value and intrinsic value, right? So those things will come. I must have discussed all those. Here time value will disappear. Here the total is time value. Okay, no intrinsic value. Here intrinsic value will be there in the price. Here intrinsic value is there, time value is not there, no time is left now. here both will be there. Here this is, here you will have some time value, okay, some intrinsic value, whatever it is, okay, this value. So we know that this is true. Very small, two lines mathematical proof. Because we know this is true, okay, even if it's American call option, if dividends are not payable during the tenure, then it's not profitable for the buyer of the call option to exercise rather than selling it in the open market, okay. So due to this inequality, it will never happen, okay. Now we'll try to prove this one. CU for every U, okay, between T and T is always greater than or equal to SU minus K. That is what we need to prove. ST minus K e power minus R T minus T, okay, for European call option we know this small ct, this is small ct, okay, the lower bound, okay. So if you find C also, it will be greater than or equal to, this is small, remember this is capital, big capital C, greater than SU minus K e power minus R T minus U, we know this. Now we'll write this e power minus r t minus t. This is greater, okay, you can check it, the value of this, because we have minus, this will be 1 upon e power, this is positive, this is positive, okay, like this, this is a positive number, okay. If you write a number greater than 1 here, this will be less than 1 always. So I can write this is less than 1, okay, you multiply K both the sides, less than K, okay. If this will be 0, then it will be 1. So if T and T are different, this will be less than 1, okay. So now you multiply minus sign, inequality will change, right? Then you write SU here, let me write here only, SU here, add SU here, okay. Now CU, either it's greater or equal to this, so CU I can write this inequality here, right, directly, greater than SU minus K, okay. So what will happen, finally CU will be, see, this is greater than this quantity, this is greater than this, so finally this will be greater than this, this is what we have written here, okay. So what will happen, if you take the special case T is equal to T, then e power 0. If R is 0, then also it is 0. So we will not worry about this inequality, okay. This will be greater than or equal to this one. So small three lines derivation, okay. Because we know this is true, then if you sell it, you will get this. If you exercise, you will get this at any time in between T to T. But this is greater than this. So you know that though you can make some profit because there is a difference and you are in the profit side, but then you will get more profit if you sell it to other party, okay, that way you can think.